Okay, today's topic will be features of Java. The first feature of Java will be simple. Simple and small language. When we compare with the other languages like C and C++, many complex concepts has been reduced here. Example, the external pointers, the multiple inheritance and the operator overloading, everything has been removed. So that is how it is called as in simple language. If you know any object-oriented programming languages, learning Java is as simple as that. So the next feature will be object-oriented. Object-oriented, when we see, compared to C++ and C, Java is fully featured with object. Almost everything in Java is an object. All the program codes and data resides within the classes and the objects. The object model in Java is simple and easy to understand. Almost all data types are objects. Say for example, the files and the strings, etc., everything is object oriented. Potentially, it is better code organization and reuse. So that is about the second feature. When we come with the third feature, which is called as platform independent and portable. So the most important feature of Java is this, the platform independent and portable. How we say Java is platform independent and portable? Java programs can be moved from one system to another anywhere at any time. After compilation of Java program, we will be getting a dot class file, which is called as a bytecode, where the user and the machine can't understand. So it is also called as an intermediate code, resides in JVM, which is nothing but Java Virtual Machine. So this class file can be taken and executed and into any machine and any operating system, which is without the source code. That is how it is called as platform independent. So in simple, Java programs can be executed on any processor like Pentium, Celeron, dual core and so on. So hence it is also called as an architecture neutral. So the next fourth striking feature of Java is the secure. So although Java is platform independent and portable, how do we say it's a secure language? Security is the most important issues in all programming language, especially when we connect it over the internet. So threat of virus and abuse of resources are everywhere. So Java system not only verify all memory access, but also ensure that no viruses are communicated within an applet. So that is how it is very much secure. So coming with the fifth important feature, which is nothing but the robust. So next feature is about the robust. How Java is called as in robust languages? Robust means strong. So a robust program is one that does not fail. Java programs are very strong as they do not crash easily like a C and C++. So it is having its own strong memory allocation and it is having its own automatic garbage collection and mechanism. So it provides a powerful exception handling and type checking mechanism. That's how Java is called as in robust language. Coming to the next feature, which is dynamic. Java is called as a dynamic language. It is capable of dynamically linking into new class libraries, methods and objects. Java program supports functions which is written in C, C++, and these functions are all also called as native methods. So that is how the features of dynamic. When we compare to the next feature, which is called as an interpreter. As I told you, Java programs, which is called as an object source code, executed will convert it into a .java file. So this Java source file, which is a .java file, after compilation, it produces a .class file, which is called as a bytecode, otherwise it is called as an intermediate file. Hence, an interpreter is needed to run the class file from the JVM to get an output. So Java is the only language which will do both the compilation as well as an interpretation. That is the next compiling feature of Java. Next comes the high performance. So when we see the high performance, Java performance is impressive for an interpreter language, mainly due to the use of an intermediate bytecode. So the Java architecture is designed in such a way that it can reduce the overheads during the runtime. So when we compare with the distributed, the next feature, Java is designed as a distributed language for creating an applications on networks. So it has the ability to share both the data as well as the program. Java applications can open, access remote objects on internet as easily as they can do in the local system. So when it comes to the last one, which is nothing but the multi-threader, last before, multi-threader, it means handling multiple tasks simultaneously. Java supports multi-threaded programs, which means that we don't need to wait for an application to finish one task before beginning the another. So simultaneously each and every task will be performing using the processor. So that is how the feature of Java, which is on multi-threading. Coming with the next one, which is nothing but the distributed. Although Java is a multi-threaded language, although it is having a high performance, Java is coming as acts as a distributed language in the sense it is designed as a distributed language for creating an applications on networks. So these are all the features of Java. So simple, object oriented, platform independent and portable, and then we have the secure, and comes the robust, and then dynamic, interpreter, high performance, multi-threaded, and comes the distributed. So how Java is compiled and interpreted? Any programmer, Java programmer, can open a text editor which is called as a notepad via any other text editor. Type the source code in the text editor and compile it. Once the compiler compiles it, it will be saved with the .java file. Once it has been compiled, the source code is converted into a bytecode. So the Java compiler will convert the source code into the bytecode. So the .java file is converted into a .class file. So we use a command prompt, and the command which is used is called as Java C. So once the Java C is used and being compiled, .java file will convert it into a .class file. So then there is an interpreter which converts this .class file using a Java command or applet viewer command or a Netscape command and converts the bytecode. And this bytecode interpreter will take the help of an hardware and an operating system and converts this bytecode into an output code. So Java will be used for the normal codes and applet viewer will be exclusively used for the applet programs. And Netscape command will be used only for the internet programs. So this is how Java is compiled and interpreted.